हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, मिसेस गुरमीत हियर। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ आवर पेपर, दैट इज राइटिंग स्किल। राइटिंग इज ए स्किल टू कन्वे अवर आइडियाज, अवर फीलिंग्स, एंड इट कैन बी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ नोटिस, रिपोर्ट, मैसेज, पैराग्राफ और अ लेटर। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस लेटर राइटिंग। लेटर, at first I am going to tell you what is letter. Letter is a written communication through which we can express our ideas, our feelings, and it is the common form in written communication. These letters are of two type, formal, and the second type is informal. In informal letters mostly those letter includes which we write to our friends and relatives to maintain our contact with them, but that type of letters are not in our course. So I am going to tell you about the formal letters, and these formal letters includes business letters and official letters, like making inquiries and asking for information. Second type is sending replies and giving information. Next is placing order. Suppose you want to buy anything in bulk, then we place order for that, or sending replies. It also includes letter making complaints or registering complaint. Next is letters to the school or college authorities regarding admission. Suppose you want inquiry regarding admission, any school issue is there, complaint regarding that, requirement of courses, and even you know the courses offered by the school or college, then you write letter related to that. Yes, students, these are the types of business and official letters which we have to do in our course. Yes, students, see how to write a good business letter. Qualities of a good business letter. First one is be brief, clear and to the point. It means letter which you are writing, it should be brief according to the word limit, and mostly word limit is 100 to 120. Don't try to exceed the word limit. Try to write the letter in the word limit. It should be clear and to the point. Next is the first para should indicate the theme of the letter. It means the letter should be divided in paragraphs, and the first paragraph, the very first paragraph, tell us about the theme of the letter. Next, use simple and direct language. After it, even while lodging a complaint, be polite. Suppose you are registering a complaint, but in your language be polite. Next is avoid boring remarks. No boring remarks should be there. Use a proper layout or format. Always use a proper format. And after this, now I am going to tell you about the format. How? Now see the format. Always remember, your letter should be in accurate format. Now we use block style in writing letters, and also students remember, no indentation should be there. Indentation, it means suppose you are writing from this line, no space you have to leave here. At first we write sender's address. Always remember, you can write it in minimum 2 line and in maximum 4 lines. Sender's address can be in minimum 2 or in maximum 4 lines. And also remember, there should be a sequence in writing address. We always start from the small area to the large area. As at first you write house number, then street, after that colony, or whatever ward number is, after that city, then state. Okay, then leave a single line यू हैव टू गिव स्पेस ऑफ सिंगल लाइन इन ईच पार्ट ऑफ फॉर्मेट. फर्स्ट इज सेंडर्स एड्रेस, लीव ए सिंगल लाइन एंड मेंशन डेट. नाउ सी हियर, डोंट राइट डेट इन दिस वे. ओके, ओनली यू हैव टू राइट लाइक दिस. Suppose today is 9th September 2020. No need to write any, to put any punctuation mark. You can also write it like September 9. Now you will use here punctuation mark. You will use put comma here. September 9. 2020. But this way, if you write like this 9 9 20, this one is wrong. Don't write in this way. Only write like this or this, any one way you can choose. Okay, after that again leave a, give space of single line and receiver's address. Receiver's address, or we can also say it inside address. Inside address. Okay, this address should be minimum in 3 lines or maximum in 4 lines. You can't write it minimum in 2 lines. As I told you, sender's address we can write it in 2 lines also. But receiver's address, it should be in minimum 3 or maximum in 4 lines. After that, give space of single line and write salutation. Salutation, it means how you address someone, like sir. You can also like madam or dear sir, dear madam should be there. Or suppose you are writing to a firm, then you can also write only sirs. Okay, salutation should be there, and in any way you can write. Sir can be there, madam, dear sir, dear madam, or only sirs. This one is salutation. It means the way of addressing the person. After this, we write subject and put colon after the subject. Don't write like this. This one is the wrong way to write a letter. After subject, just put colon and your subject, on whatever subject you are writing, your subject should be in 7 to 8 words. Try to give your try to write your subject in 7 to 8 words. Try to write it in short. Okay, after that write, leave a single line and write body of the letter. Body of the letter, here you have to write in the first paragraph. You can also divide it in paragraph. In the first paragraph you have to give the theme or the subject, whatever you are writing about. Next, what's the content? And after that, you have to give your suggestions, your ideas, your requirements. According to the letter, the clause should be different. The last paragraph should be different according to your content, according to your subject. After that, complimentary clause, or you can also say subscription. Subscription, it means yours faithfully, or you can also write yours truly. Last one is complimentary clause or subscription. It can be yours faithfully and yours truly. And from left side you have to write all this. from this line. Give no space. Formal letters are always written in block style, and in informal letters we can use semi block style. It means indentation is there in those type of letters. In informal letters there is indentation, but there is no place of indentation in formal letter. Again listen, informant, at first sender's address, it means the person who is writing that letter, you have to give address of that person. After that, date is written. Then receiver's address, it means the person to whom you are writing, you have to write the address of that person. Then after this, salutation, in a single word, single or one or two words, you have to address someone. Dear sir, dear madam, sir, madam, or sirs, like this you have to address. After that, subject is written, it should be in 7 to 8 words. Then body of the letter, and already I told you, we divide the body of letter in 3 parts. First one is theme, next is content, and last is your suggestions or whatever you want to say regarding that. Last is complimentary clause or subscription, and mostly we write yours faithfully or yours truly here. Okay, the first type of letter that I am going to tell you is placing order. See the heading, as librarian, Modern Senior Secondary School, Noida, write a letter to the sales manager, Orient Blackson, Noida, placing an order for some books for your school library. You are a librarian of Modern Senior Secondary School. To you are, it means this one is the address of the sender. You are writing this letter. You are librarian. So we will mention here Modern Senior Secondary School. This one is the sender's address. Modern Senior Secondary School, Noida. After that, leave a single line and mention date. No indentation is there. We are writing here from this line. Modern Senior Secondary School, Noida. Leave a single line, mention date. 9 September or September 9. Okay. Then receiver's address, to whom you are writing. Here is written, write a letter to, and we are writing to the sales manager. Write at first the sales manager, Orient Blackson, Noida. Same address is given here. This one is the receiver's address. After that, salutation. You are writing to the manager, so we have written here, dear sir. The manager can be a madam also, but we are writing here, dear sir or dear madam, whatever you have to write, okay? Dear sir, then subject. Our subject is placing order for books. You can also write like this, ki order for books for school library. Okay, this one is the subject. After that, we will write its body. Now, see the body of the letter. At first, introductory para. It means whatever we want, for what we are placing order. Regarding that, we have to write, we are in need of some books for the school library. Please send the following books at the earliest for the current session. It means for the session which is going on, we want books for that. Just suppose you are suppose you want to place order for sports material, then at this place you can also write, we are in need of some sports material for our school, not for library, because you also know sport material is not needed in library. Books are needed there. Okay, we are in need of some books for the school library. Kindly send the following. And after that, leave a single line and make this performa. This table you have to meet. 4 parts should be there, and at least 4 items you have to mention. Minimum 4 items should be there. Serial number, then name of the book. After this, that class you have to mention, and then quantity. It means the number of books which you want to receive there, or which you for which you are giving your order. First serial number, first number is Hornbill English. You can also mention here NCERT. Okay, it's for 11th standard, and quantities, it means 25 books are needed in your library. Second one is snapshot, it's also of English, 11th and 25. secondary physics by SC Jain. You can also mention the writer's name, 12th and the quantity. Then first flight English, it's of 10th standard and the number of books is 40. According to your choice, you can mention the number 5, 10, 20, 40, whatever you want. Okay, you can mention that. After writing the table, now you have to write your terms and condition regarding that. And you will write before dispatching the books. It means before the delivery. Before dispatching the books, please ensure that only the latest editions are being supplied and the books are not soiled or dirty. It means the book should be in proper condition. Also check that each book has complete pages and no duplication of pages should be there. It means the books should be original. You can write it in your own language, but the matter should be like this. Okay. We would expect discount on the purchase. Whatever the discount was there, you also write your expectation regarding that. We would expect discount on the purchase. I do hope the discount offered in the past shall be applicable this year too. You have listened about the discount which they gave last year, and you want the discount, same discount this year also. Next, after changing paragraph, you will write payment will be made through check. It means mode of payment you have to write, through check or cash. Payment will be made through check after approval by the library committee. It means when the library committee approved those books, after that you will made payment. Payment will be made through check payment will be made through check after approval by the library committee, and at last subscription is there. Yours faithfully, write a name. Sometimes name is given in the heading, but in this heading no name is given, only designation is given there, post is given there. Then you will write yours faithfully, any name you can write here, and after that write designation. It means you have to write librarian. Okay, and students, similarly you have to do two other topics also. First one is order for sports item, and next one is order for stationery. Okay, again listen this, you have to write two other topic. Try to write them, try to solve them. First one is order for sports material, and the next one is order for stationery. These two you have to write, and taking screenshot of this letter, you have to write this one also in your notebooks. Thanks, students.